But Jacob Olanya, the MP for Omoro County, as Speaker for the 11th Parliament. The MP for Omoro County, who is Jacob Olanya, as I've just said, has been elected as the Speaker of the 11th Parliament after beating off stiff competition from outgoing Speaker and former boss, Right Honourable Rebecca Kadaga. Olanya polled 310 votes from an election which took place at the Kololo Independence Grounds and was observed by President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, the head of state. Kadaga was quick to concede defeat and reached out to her successor to congratulate him upon his victory. Let's have the details.
I am Onibeti Ongom, Member of Parliament, Oyam County South. Move under Rule 5, Sub Rule 10, to second the nomination of Jacob L. Olanya, MP for the post of the Speakership for the 11th Parliament.
I move under Rule 5, Sub Rule 10, to second the nomination of Samuju Ibrahim.
Your Lordship, I've come to second Honorable Alitwala Rebecca Kadaga.
The hotly contested election of the Speaker of Parliament started at noon with Bright Remirama, MP in Singiro North, and Betty Amongin, MP Oyam County, nominating Jacob Olanya respectively. Luka North MP Stephen Kisa and Geoffrey Macho nominated Rebecca Kadaga, while Alan Sewanyana, MP Makinde West, plus Moses Atin, MP Soroti Division East, nominated Ibrahim Semujunganda for three horse race.
Honorable Olanya has developed a high successful career path in parliamentary practice and procedure. He offers extensive practical hands-on experience in legislative matters. He is a believer in parliamentary system of representative democracy and is an ardent believer in procedural powers and orderly conduct of business. Honorable members, I beg that we vote for Jacob L. Olanya, Speaker of the 11th Parliament.
Distinguished colleagues, members of Parliament, of the three arms of government, it is the Parliament that represents the downtrodden, the less privileged, the underprivileged, and the unknown segments of society. It is therefore important that the people of Uganda, through their elected representatives, should be given an opportunity to determine the leadership of Parliament. It is our considered view that the candidate who will champion the cause of the people of Uganda is the Right Honorable Rebecca Kadaga.
Election presided over by Chief Justice Alfonso Owinyidolo lasted over 5 hours as MPs casted ballots in alphabetical order. President Yoweri Museveni strictly observed proceedings in a tent erected aside the polling station. At 5:30 p.m., the presiding officer announced results declaring Jacob Olanya duly elected with 310 votes. Rebecca Kadaga, who ran as an independent after missing NRM ticket, polled 197 votes, with FDC's Ibrahim Semujunganda coming last with only 15 votes.
The total number of votes cast were 524, valid ones were 522, there were two invalid votes cast. One of your members chose both Kadaga and Olanya, so wrote both names. So there's no provision for having two speakers of parliament, can only have one. So that one. And then the other one wrote a name of a person who is a stranger to the contest, who did not stand. So these were two. Therefore, Jacob, Honorable Jacob Lokori Olanya, has obtained the majority votes of 310 votes. I therefore now declare Honorable Jacob Lokori Olanya, who has obtained 310 votes cast, as the Speaker-elect of the 11th Parliament of Uganda.
Kadaga, who has run a rough race with Olanya, shocked many when she moved immediately to congratulate her successor, which amazed members of parliament. Olanya immediately took an oath before receiving instruments of power, including a mess, a national coat of arms, and the national flag from the president.
Jacob Lokori Olanya, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will at all times well and truly serve the Republic of Uganda in the office of the Speaker, and that I will support and uphold the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda as by law established. So help me God.
He was immediately dragged to his chair, where he made his acceptance speech and pledged to mend relationship with his opponents.
Honorable members, this particular election has been particularly challenging. As a result, expectations are high, fears and uncertainties exist, but together we should build the bridges, mend the relationship, and rebuild friendship, and replace despair with hope. I pledge to provide leadership through this and walk the talk.
Olanya has also pledged to deliver Uganda to the middle income status through good appropriation and legislation.
The declared mission for us at this moment as the 11th Parliament, and in line with the Vision 2040, is to deliver Uganda to middle income status. Every generation has its mission. It can either fulfill it or betray it. We are the generation of parliamentarians chosen by God and elected by the people of Uganda and given this task. This parliament, like all parliaments around the world, is the highest legal forum. It is tasked with the responsibility of approving laws, policies, budgets meant for the implementation.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Kampala.